So we have created our game. However, what happens if we want to go ahead and put this on a server for other people to play, or just go ahead and build it so we can have it locally and play it ourselves? Of course, on a production environment, you're not going to want to go ahead and run npm run dev every time. Of course, we also have this colorful comment in here, meaning that we are in a local development environment. Now, just to kind of give you some of the background around this, if we just have a look in here, we know that when we are going ahead and running npm run dev, what we're doing is we're running this script here. That's going ahead and running Webpack, which subsequently uses webpack.config.js to go ahead and pull everything together. We already briefly mentioned that earlier. Now, when you're in a development environment, this is going to be different to a production environment, because you're not going to want auto reloading. You're not going to want production set on within Phaser. So instead, when we run over in package.json deploy, this is going to go ahead and call Webpack, but it's going to use the Webpack production configuration, which is over here. What that's going to do is minify everything. It's going to build everything together, but for a production environment. So you can go ahead and have a look through this if you want, just to kind of get a good idea as to what's going on here. So let's go over and explore what happens when we run npm run deploy, see what goes on. So you see it's building as normal, but it's using that Webpack production configuration. And once this is finished, we end up with a production built version of our game. Now, nothing's changed inside of here. All that's happened is bundle.js and vendor.bundle.js are now ready for production. So the question is, how do we get this working? Well, the trick here is to have a look inside of index.html, which is what we've been using over here to preview our game. Of course, this isn't working because we're not running npm run dev, but essentially this is all we need. So what I'm going to do is copy this over to a new directory here into a new file, and this I happen to have open just using MAMP, so just using a local web server. Now, of course, this isn't working at the moment because these files can't be found. So what we can do is come over to our breakout directory, go over to the distribution folder just here. We don't need the maps, although you can copy them over if you want to. We're going to take these and we're going to copy them over to our breakout distribution folder that we have open using MAMP. So I'm going to go ahead and paste these in. And of course, if we just head over to the text editor and go ahead and modify this, because we've created a JS directory, I'm just also going to go ahead and just clear this up as I like. So let's go ahead and make sure this is all nice and tidy. We have a div here with an ID of content. This is where the canvas element is going to be placed. So like we already saw, Phaser works using a canvas element. We're also setting the margin and the padding here to 0, so there's no padding on the outside. And of course, we can go ahead and change over the title if we want, not breakfast, breakout. Okay, so now that we've done that, if we head over and give this a refresh, we now have a almost working game, but you will notice that some of the assets, or all of the assets, are not working. This still works. We can still, you know, play the game, but there are no images available. That's because Webpack isn't going to bundle together all of your images, of course, inside of a JS file. So what we actually need is an assets directory. So let's go ahead and create an assets directory. And again, we're going to come over to our normal breakout that we copied all of our assets over to. We're going to grab our images here. We're going to go ahead and copy these, and we're going to come over and we're going to paste them into that assets directory like so. So now when we go ahead and give this a refresh, we still don't see any. So let's see where these are trying to come from. So breakout and paddle.png. Let's take a look at this and see where this wants to be. So assets, images, of course. So let's create an images directory. Go ahead and paste these over. And we're also going to need the loader bars as well, because they're just part of the boilerplate that we've been using. So if I give this a refresh now, notice that this is working perfectly. We still actually do have this comment, so that's obviously just going to be there, you know, normally. But we now have something that we can go ahead and upload. So if you wanted to, you could go ahead and distribute all of the files inside of here, upload them, and you're done. Alternatively, if you're pushing up to source code and automatically deploying, you could just push this entire thing up, and then once you've done that, run npm run deploy. That will build it inside of here, and people will still have access to it. But it's a lot better to just copy everything over once you're done and ready to deploy it. So there we go. That is how we build our project and transfer it over and use it outside of the context of our development environment.